But my head is
social instability, injustice, and anti-democracy ruling among the G20 participants. So today, here we are. We tell you the G20 members and the whole world that this man is, he and his force are violating the freedom of life on Ethiopian land. If you listen to me, here I tell you about him. There is a long history of gross human rights violation reported and allegedly being committed, incited, or empowered by this government. Only some of them have been investigated by well-respected international human rights organizations. This includes the following. 1. The Antioch in 2005 and in 2006. And 2. The Oromo in 2005. 3. The killing of election prosecutors in Addis Ababa in 2005. And 4. The Ogaden and the Somali in 2008. Most of the other reports and views included the following chronological list are well known among Ethiopians, but have not been officially investigated by an international human rights organization. The one is in December 1991, after the mother-led tyrannical people, Liberation Front, TPLF, came to power and prior to officially beginning the new government of the Ethiopian People's Revolutionary Democratic Front. TPLF forces killed 150 Amhara civilians in a small village of Harbakuru in Harar region. The second, in March 1992, 92 Oromo civilians and peacefully protesting for Oromo autonomy were killed by the government troops. And 3, in April 1992, government troops again killed another 150 Amhara civilians in the town of Bedeno in the same region. And the 4th, in December 1992, the RPDF forces abducted another a mother and a brother of suspected ES Derg militarian from their home and massacred them in a remote place called Gamadro, forest of Chakacho zone, reported in Human Rights Special Report in 1996. And the 5th, in January 1993, during a student rally against the government, 6 students from Addis Ababa University were shot and killed again by the government security. And 6, 1993 and 1994, EPRDF forces murdered innocent persons, 18 people. people. Simply, they showed unhappiness at the wife, the force killed a mother because she gave birth to a suspected rebel. And this is also reported by the Ethiopian Human Rights Council in 1996. In October 1995, Ato Muhammad Abba Mecha and Ato Ashef Walde Zadik both judge of Gimbo Oroda Court in Kaffa Administrative Zone of southern Ethiopia were at their regular duties in the bench of the court were suddenly surrounded by the armed policemen with AK-4 automatic guns under the direction of EBRDF officials, and because they were conducting an investigation onto a number of corruption and rape cases carried out by the EBRDF officials. This shows the non-existence of the judiciary independence. And the next one is in September 1997, to death, thousands of Chekacha people were evicted from their land in order to establish a coffee and tea plantation. As a result, the population were left to starve and lost their possession in the Chekacha zone. And the land was given to East Africa Coffee and Tea Development Company connected to EPRDF officials. And the next one is 1997 and 2004. A massive resettlement project was designed in the Chekacha land, and local population were forcefully evicted from their land, and all natural resources used by the population was destroyed. All forests covered with intentionally cruel in order to prevent the population escaping in the jungle and challenging the government authority. Forests have been burned and precious flora.